The time a client asked me for $150. This is when I was a beginner nail tech and I've only been taking clients for 2 to 3 months. I had a client and she was super nice, really nice. Eventually she started texting me late at night, venting to me about really personal things going on in her life. At the time I didn't understand this was meant to be a professional relationship, so I just listened to her and tried to be there for her. Then one day she DM'd me saying that she's in a situation and she needs $150 and that she will send it to me the next day at 3:30 a.m. Then she unsent it and texted my number the same thing. In the text, she also added her phone number so I could pay ID her. I texted her saying I can't loan her that. Then she asked for $40 instead and she'll add to it. I thought this was a bit much at this point, so I told her I don't think this is something you should be asking me. She apologized and said she knew she would return it. I just didn't reply. I never heard from her after that. After that experience, I realized that I really need to set up my boundaries within this business and keep things professional. Before this, I had another experience where I didn't set up boundaries, but this was.
My older sister has never in her entire 35 or 36, honestly, I'm not even sure how old she is, ever put acrylic nails on. So I decided I wanted to give her her first set and made sure that they were super bougie. I'm sorry, that was like really extra. But anyway, I had to obviously prep her nails and like, yo, her cuticles were so thick, so thick. Almost had to pull out, you know, those like... You know those like hedge trimmers that they use on the bushes? Almost had to pull one of those out. But anyway, I don't know if you guys noticed in the beginning of the video, I probably should have said this first, but she has this like formal event that she has to go to, and actually I'm going to it as well. But she wanted to match her nails like closely to the dress that she's wearing, and I'm no color mixer maker person, but you know, the purple that I made is like kind of similar to the dress, so you know, nobody will really notice unless they're, you know, really staring, which, you know what, they probably will, because these babies came out nice. I don't know why I woke up in such a good mood today. Like, it's November right now, I'm living in New Jersey at the moment, and it's like 60 degrees outside. Usually by now I'd be like pulling out the winter coat, winter boots, and snow shovels. That was dramatic. It doesn't really snow like until December or January, but you know, still, bro, you can't even look at the shape, look at that shape. Those little squares, like, I bet you those are some nice 90 degree angles. I don't even know what I'm talking about, honestly. Oh, shit. I'm sorry. I forgot how nice they look. Oh, and the butterflies. Oh, that French, though. Oh, my. You know what? I just remembered. Look how awkward my sister is. Oh. So awkward. What is she doing? She's tickling the air.
I've been doing my own nails using gel extensions for over a year now, and this is how I get them to last for on 3 weeks, no lifting or popping, part one. So first step is cuticle and nail prep. These steps are essential in getting your nails to last long. I like to start with clean nails, so I just use these alcohol prep pads from Amazon. Then I use a cuticle remover. I have these two you can get from Amazon for around $6. I love the Sally Hansen one because of the mess-free squeeze bottle it comes in. It makes it super easy. However, the other is just as good, but it may easily spill, so I pour it into a small dish beforehand. Then I wait around 15 seconds and use a cuticle pusher to gently push back my cuticles, basically lightly scraping my nail plate. Then using the opposite end to actually get all of that dead skin off. This is optional, but you can also cut your cuticles. Next, I use a buffer. I like to use these mini ones and lightly buff away the shine of your nail. It should look like this. I'm also brushing away any dust from that. After that, it's a good time to apply any sunscreen or put on UV protecting gloves such as these from Melody Suzy. Protecting your skin is super important, especially if you use a UV LED lamp frequently like I do. Part 2 on how I get my gel extension nails to last. Now it's time for nail prep using a dehydrator and primer. These again are essential. The dehydrator just takes oils off the nails, but it can also be done with acetone. I just pour it into a small dish and apply it with a cleaning brush. Next is a primer. This just creates a sticky layer on the nail, which will help the gel adhere. It is also super important to not touch your nails after both of these steps, as the oils on your fingers will just be put back on your nails. Now it's time for the gel. We're using an extend slash builder slash nailed glue gel. It goes by many names, and this is just a gel much thicker than a top coat or a base coat, so it cannot be substituted. In my experience, the thicker the gel, the better, as when it's runny, it likes to flood when applying the tips. I'll explain this in another video. I paint a thin coat of the gel on my nails and use acetone and a cleaning brush if it gets on my skin. Then fully cure the nail in a big lamp, which means it has at least 36 watts for 60 seconds. Bonus if your lamp has a reflective bottom. This helps ensure gel is cured evenly. Part 3 on how I get my nails to last around 3 weeks, no lifting or popping. So now that your cuticles and nails are prepped, let's talk nail tips. Choosing the wrong size can make your nails pop off easier. It is important that they fit perfectly sidewall to sidewall like this and that it doesn't overlap on the skin or leave a gap. There are also two types of nail tips, natural and sculpted slash structured. Natural tips don't have high apexes, which means they're better for flat nail beds like mine. Structured nail tips do have high apexes and are better for curved nails. However, if you use them on flat nails, you'll definitely need more gel as there is a bigger gap between the nail and the tips. You also want to apply the tips at an angle like this, making sure the edge of the tip lays straight. Length also matters. These are medium nail tips and they look medium on my nails, but on smaller nail beds they may look long. Now nail tip prep. I use a coarse file to thin out the round side of the nail tip so it blends well with the natural nail. Next, I etch the inside of the nail tip either physically with a small cutoff piece of a nail buffer or chemically with a primer like this, just moving back and forth with a brush. I actually like to use both, just make sure the etching exceeds the nail length. How to paint your nails perfectly. So first I start by wiping the excess polish off the stem of both sides so it doesn't drip down the brush. Then I like to swipe the brush on one side, but if you have shorter nails, I would also wipe it halfway on the other side. Next, I just center the brush around the middle of the nail and slowly push it towards the cuticle until I almost reach it and then quickly swipe up. I use the side or corner of the brush to slowly follow the sides of my nail and then quickly swipe up again. After that, I go down the middle for an even coat. I find that changing the position of my nail to see the sides or using a small item like this nail polish box can really help. But the key to getting a perfect mani is using nail polish remover and a cleanup brush to wipe away any excess polish. I wait about 4 to 5 minutes for the polish to dry, but usually it's dry by the time I finish one hand. For the second coat, I just repeat the same steps except I like having a tiny bit more polish on the brush to get a smooth and even layer. Also, don't forget to cap the free edge for long wear, it really helps with chipping. Lastly, I'm adding a top coat which can help smoothen out imperfections, and you're done. This is the easiest way to DIY your own nails at home. So to make my nails longer, I use the gel extension method. It's so fast and easy. All you do is prep the nails, apply the tips, shape with a file, and you're literally done. As for quick and easy nail art, using gel strips is the best option. I'm using a gel strip kit from Foxology, and it comes with everything you need. 30 strips of the nail design, prep pad, cuticle pusher, nail file, and top coat. To apply them, all you need to do is prep the tips, find the right sizes, and which side of your strip will fit your nail bed better. Choose a design, then peel off the strip and place it on your nail. You don't even need to worry about applying it perfectly because you can easily peel off the strip if you messed up and try again. After that, file off any excess on the free edge and cure the strips in place. Last step is to add a top coat and do a final cure. This is a super beginner-friendly option and great for those who struggle with nail art or painting their nails.
Trying DIY gel strips on my natural nails using this cute paint kit. First, cuticle remover and cleaning my nails.
I'm stylish. Black talk, big t-shirt, Billy.
Finding the right sizes. Applying the strip. Filing off the excess. Curing to set them in place. Applying a top coat and adding gems before curing. So cute. You can't even tell they are strips. Story time. Client from hell. Hi, my appointment is coming up, and I wanted to know if you can fit in my two sisters. Me. Hey girl, unfortunately, I have appointments after you. I don't understand why you are being horrible, just please fit in. Me. Sorry, but they've been booked for a month, I can't cancel on them. Okay, well I hope you know you're being distasteful and rude. I will be at the okay. Her appointment day comes up. Hello, we're on the way. Confirming you said yes to all three of us today, right? Me? Hey, actually no. Please scroll up and read our past conversation. I let you know I won't have space today. Your sorry. Attitude is disgusting. You said yes, and you're wasting our time. This is the worst customer Me. Service. I let you know that I wasn't able to and you went ahead and decided to bring them. Sorry, but I can't do anything. We are outside. Please open.
If anyone's wanting to know how to get revenge on someone who spread rumors about you, listen to this story and it may come in handy. So I had a friend that we can call Miranda who was obsessed with me. I was genuinely friends with her, but she would never give me a break. I could not get a breather from her at any point in time. Everywhere I went, she went. And this girl would actually get so upset with me anytime I would go over to another friend's house. I knew she was really insecure and just trying to get attention, so I tried to be patient with her. However, one day I just could not take it anymore. I got into a massive fight with her over how overprotective she is. I literally said, "You are a stage 5 clinger." And in response, this girl ended up joining my basketball and softball team, which I've been on for forever. She told her mom that I was bullying her, which was a complete lie, but then her mom went to the coaches. She got me kicked off the team, and they continued to spread rumors about me. I ended up losing my best friends and even my boyfriend over the rumors that she spread about me. So that's when I decided to get revenge. So I decided that I was going to send her over an apology gift with makeup in it, which was a mix of drugstore items and poison.
Story time about how I catfished all the popular boys in my grade and they found out about it. So a little background information. I was at a new school. I just started there probably like 4 months before this happened. And I was best friends with this one girl. We're going to call her Kate. And Kate had a crush on this guy. We're going to call him Alex. And he liked her back, but she wanted to see if he was loyal. Well, at least that's what it was supposed to be at first. But then he started to actually fall in love with this bitch. So then I started feeling bad and I told my friend that I just wanted to end it right there. And she was like, "No, let's keep going. This is so funny." Mind you, this was the boy that she liked. So at that point, I was like, whatever. And then he asked to meet up at the mall. So then we took him on a whole goose chase around the whole mall. Like, we were like, "Oh, we're in this store. Never mind, we're in this one." And the only reason why we got away with it was because he thought he saw us in the one store. So then we broke up with him and we started talking to all the other popular boys. And on this fake account, we said that we went to a different school. Well, one of the kids at that school said that he never saw us there, like, for part two.
My best friend's boyfriend starts DMing me on Instagram. He confesses that he had a crush on me when we were in college together, and I told him that I did too. Disclaimer, this is not my story time. From that day on, he would DM me every single day and we would just flirt back and forth. I started feeling really, really guilty and I told him one day, "I can't do this anymore." That's when he told me he also felt guilty and that the best thing was for us to stop talking, so we did. I was so sad. A few weeks passed by and my best friend asked me if she could have the apartment all to herself because she's planning a romantic dinner for him. I said yes, but I felt so jealous. Left the apartment because I realized that I was so in love with him. I went to the supermarket and ate a whole pack of Oreo cookies and went to the movies. I get a text message from my best friend asking me to come home immediately. My stomach sank and I thought she had found out. When I get there, she's crying and she says that he broke up with her. I asked if he said why and she said because he was in love with another woman. My stomach sank again. I was there with her the entire night while she cried, knowing her boyfriend left her because of me. Part 3.
Guys, I just broke up with my most loyal client. This is our very last set together, so here goes nothing. We just did gel X with tapered square nails. I'm using the A method to create my French, and then I just filled the rest of the nail with black. And then I'm gonna go in with this pink chrome. This chrome color comes in about a set of 8 on Amazon. I linked it in my storefront if you guys wanna buy it. I really like it because they have a bunch of different colors. And this is how her nails turned out. I'm obsessed. I am super, super sad, but I'm just happy that she's on to bigger and better things. And I wish you the best, Rachel. I love you. Bye. I'm gonna cry.
Another beginner story time. Sends me a picture of a medium set with blue marble on all nails. That'll be $35. And I do require a $5 deposit. Finishes doing her nails day of the appointment. Sends me $35 through Cash App. My mom wants to talk to you. Why did you charge her so expensive? You said $30. She already gave the $5. No, ma'am, I'm so sorry for the misunderstanding, but the $5 was only the deposit. Salons don't do this. They charge way cheaper and they do better. We're never going back there again.